A Canadian man is facing years in a Cuban prison for killing a fellow Canadian tourist in a boating accident. It is the second time Tufik Benhamish has been convicted over the incident. Ryan Hicks is here with more on this story. What are we learning today?
Tufik Benhamish faces 4 years in prison after this latest conviction, and he thought his ordeal was over in July. That's when the Cuban Supreme Court overturned his original conviction for criminal negligence causing death. The Cuban government, though, decided to take him to trial a second time over the same incident. And this decision came down on Christmas Eve, where a lower court found him guilty once again. Now, we just got a statement from Global Affairs Canada on this case, and Global Affairs Canada spokesperson Sylvain Leclerc says Canadian consular officials are in contact with local authorities to gather additional information and continue to provide consular services to Mr. Benhamish and his family. And this all stems from a July 2017 incident in Cayo Coco. Mr. Benhamish was driving a speedboat with his wife and his two young daughters. It veered out of control, killing an Ontario mother of three. Benhamish says he was not drinking. He says a staff member told him the boat was easy to operate. On a Facebook post, he wrote, "The guide explained to us how to start and stop the boat, assuring us it was easy and that the boat would never flip over. He said, 'Please believe me, this boat cannot flip over. You only need to follow my instructions.'" Also, he says he was not told about his legal and safety obligations. All these twists and turns have caused confusion and anxiety for Benhamish and his family. They want the Canadian government to put more pressure on Cuban officials. In November, Benhamish's family and supporters went to Ottawa to protest outside of the Cuban embassy. Let's hear from Benhamish's lawyer in Montreal.
The result is that it is essential that the Canadian government, having watched this joke court, local court, intervene with Cuba and say enough is enough. I think we have the influence. All the Canadian government has to do is say that there will be a warning about travel to Cuba, and Cuba will immediately, I'm certain, take into account our position.
And Benhamish remains outside of prison while he awaits his second appeal.
Thanks for the latest, Ryan.
You're welcome.